World Championship Wrestling presents WCW Saturday Night along with the American Dream Dusty Rhodes. I am Tony Schiavone. As we ended Nitro this past Monday, a very bizarre situation involving the Macho Man Randy Savage and Miss Elizabeth, and not a good time for the Macho Man to get involved in something like this, Dream.
Well, I tell you what, Tony, bad timing. Yeah, you know, we will discuss today the ongoing saga, if you will, of the New World Order, WCW, where the big boys play as we approach another huge pay-per-view called Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc. Macho Man, Sting out of whack, bad timing all the way around. How this is going to fit in here on the mothership tonight remains to be seen, but I guarantee you one thing, we better get everything in order.
We have a tremendous two-hour program. We will take you back to WCW Monday Nitro, and apparently the NWO has a driver for its car, and that is Kyle Petty. Great footage, great action as we go to the ring, the first bout on Saturday night.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is for the WCW Cruiserweight Championship, number one fall. Introducing first the challenger from the Federal District of Mexico, Juventud Guerrera.
Juventud Guerrera begins our program in this telecast. Ladies and gentlemen, a return match for the World Tag Team title. Harlem Heat will take on the new champs, Public Enemy. Plus, we're going to be talking to Nick Patrick. I'm going to be talking to the Macho Man Randy Savage about what has transpired in his career, especially over the last week, and ask him some pointed questions. We go back to David Penzer.
This opponent from Tijuana, Mexico, the WCW Cruiserweight Champion, Rey Mysterio Jr.
Here he comes, Dream. What a sensation this young man is.
Yeah, people call him a phenomenon. But I guarantee you one man that is watching this very closely, and that is the man you were standing there recently when finally Rey Mysterio Jr. got his headpiece taken away by Dean Malenko, and he's watching this thing. Yeah, talk to Nick Patrick again, you know what I mean? Flabbergast with him about the situation. And the Macho Man Randy Savage, let me tell you something, Tony, caught in a web of love once again. It's that same old story. When you leave, turn the light out. Somebody left the light on in the hall in this situation, and he's right in the middle of it.
It seems to me that maybe that Miss Elizabeth is a part of the NWO. I'm not sure. We have to find out more on
that
story.
Good. That's a real good observation, and boy. You're on top of your game tonight.
Well, there you go. How about it? And I'm going to be talking to the Macho Man about that a little bit later on. We have 2 great hours of World Championship Wrestling here. Juventud Guerrera wants to go to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc live at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, Sunday, October 27th. As the Cruiserweight Champion, he could right here. Back elbow, puts down Rey Mysterio Jr.
Yes. Whoa. I tell you what, yeah, Juventud, if he gets the opportunity right here, he will be at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Nevada. But I guarantee you one thing, high-risk maneuvers can cost you at any moment.
Juventud missed everything that time, and Rey Mysterio, just one step, has a lot of offense going his way.
Boy, I tell you, I got a lot of letters. I get fan mail this week about you last week and the interviews and all the stuff you did. People are astonished at the way you handled yourself, taking your coat off and, you know, and asking them dumbfounded questions of Nick Patrick.
Dumbfounded.
Well, it's Saturday night. The mothership's on fire. Look at that. Flip right on his butt. What?
I tell you, Nick Patrick, it's not that we want to talk to him. He says he wants to talk to us. We saw him Monday night in a neck brace.
Yeah. Anytime you give a criminal airtime, he loves it. When you're a criminal and they give you airtime like on CNN or TBS, like our mothership here, well, you're just beaming, man.
Up on you know top. What? Juventud.
Because you're going to end up writing a book about it and make $1 million.
Look at that maneuver. It's sensational. 1, 2, and no.
You're going to be mad at me right now. One of my colleagues.
Who?
You know, Iron Mike. He'd be on me, man. See, they got a great match going on over here. And you joined Tony about Nick Patrick. Well, New World Order's on my mind. It's got to be on everybody's, right or wrong.
No question about it. Backhand chop.
And I'm going to really get on Kyle Petty here tonight as the show goes on.
Big headbutt. Down goes Juventud Guerrera. Or down goes Rey Mysterio, that is, from a headbutt from Juventud Guerrera. Here goes Guerrera again. Miss. So again, the quickness showing from this Cruiserweight champion Rey Mysterio Jr., even though he's been hit with a lot of offensive moves that will slow him down. He's back to the attack once again. The fans loving Mark Curtis, the referee here, looks on. A pickup. Guerrera. Reverse spin kick in the sternum, and Guerrera feels that his moment's at hand here.
Yeah, they're evenly matched up, same size. A lot of speed possessed by both men, so much at stake. And as I said, one Iceman Dean Malenko watching this thing, you know, unfold right here on Saturday night.
Guerrera trying to pick him up.
Junior got a hook, though, had that top rope hook.
Oh, Rey Mysterio just throws him off.
Dumped him.
Rey Mysterio Jr., as you said, Dream, dumped him. Somersault on top of Juventud Guerrera, and I think maybe the back of his head may have hit the safety rail on the floor,
yeah,
right there.
And Junior's knee and legs also hit that concrete. That's okay. High-risk maneuvers are fine. But I still say they come back to not only hurt you, but haunt you. They cause defeat in most cases.
Up on top. Ooh, that'll slow you down. Hitting that steel connector to the ring post. Juventud is up. Juventud tried the Frankenstein from a springboard, and now Rey Mysterio Jr. over the incredible one, two, three wins.
Boy, he drove him home.
How about that?
WCW Cruiserweight Champion, Rey Mysterio Jr.
You can see it on his face. He earned every bit of that one. It was a tough one. And this is going to be our Pep Boys Power Pin of the Week, brought to you by Pep Boys, America's Automotive Supercenter. Dream, you take it away.
I'm going to tell you what. You talk about a power pin. It certainly was. The bottom line, Rey Mysterio Jr. now gets a step closer to Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc and defending that title. Watch out for the hook. Defending that title against, whoa, Dean Malenko. Off the top. Catches him flush outside. I thought both men were injured at this time. Then right here, you can see Frankensteiner hooks him in, drives him home. Let's go to Tony Schiavone now, rapping with Rey Mysterio Jr.
Thanks a lot, Dream. Coming up at Slim Jim's Halloween Havoc in only 3 weeks, Rey Mysterio Jr. defends his Cruiserweight title against a man that's about to be considered the number one contender, Dean Malenko. And after what happened last week, I know you have a lot of reason to get in the ring with Dean Malenko.
That's right, Tony. You know, like I said all the time, Dean Malenko, he's a great wrestler. I respect him. But there's two important things for me in the business of wrestling. And that's the championship belt, the Cruiserweight title that I have right here on my shoulder, and this mask. This mask means a lot to me. It's the most important thing for me in this business. Dean Malenko, you took away my mask. And that's not right. I don't like that. You know what? I thought you were a fair man. I thought we could go up in the ring on October 27th, Halloween Havoc, and have a good match. But you don't want it that way. Hey, I'm going after that. And I'm gonna keep this title around my waist, and I'm gonna get that mask. That mask that you took away from me.
Rey Mysterio Jr., later in this program, Dean Malenko will be here, and more Saturday night after this timeout.